morning, children, we were discussing yesterday mouth as a munching machine. So we learned one activity. So how the food is getting masticated or ground in the mouth. So today we learn about another interesting topic related to the mouth, which helps in bringing mastication, grinding, all that. So now, if we observe the chart of jaws, so upper and lower jaws, if we observe, we can see the teeth. So teeth, are they of same size and same structure, same shape? No. You are learning different type. You are observing different types of teeth. So what do we call the teeth arrangement? So the arrangement of teeth in upper and lower jaws is called a dentition. Arrangement of teeth in upper and lower jaws, we call it as dentition. And we have different types of teeth. So when we observe the chart, we are observing the different sizes teeth and different shape teeth also we are observing. So different types of teeth and which are said to be in different sizes we are observing. So that what type of dentition human beings are having means that is said to be heterodont dentition. So dentition means, you know, which is said to be the arrangement of teeth in jaws. Why it is heterodont dentition? Because human beings are having different types of teeth which are helping in doing different so the teeth which are of different types and shapes, so that arrangement we call it as heterodont dentition. And what is the relation between the shape and the different types of teeth? Are they going to help in digestion of food? Means obviously it is yes only. So the shape of the teeth is going to help in doing or bringing different functions. So different types of teeth are doing different functions. So what are the dental formula? So what is the dental formula? Means how many types of teeth are there and in the jaws how they are arranged. So that arrangement of teeth all types, so that can be known with the help of dental formula. How many types teeth means in scissors, canines, premolars and molars. So we have four types of teeth in scissors, canines, premolars and molars. So this side in lower jaw two sides and in upper jaw two sides. So all how many types of incisors are there? Canines are there, premolars are there, molars are there. So all this will be known by observing this dental formula. So 2, 1, 2, 3. So one side like this. So 2 by 2, 1 by 1, 2 by 2, 3 by 3. Is it clear to you, children? So that will give the dental formula. Human dental formula is said to be 2, 1, 2, 3. ICPM 2, 1, 2, 3. It is going to make you to understand about the how many types of teeth are there. So now let us learn what is the shape of incisors and what is its function, like that canines, premolars and molars we will discuss. So we have four types of teeth: incisors, canines, premolars and molars. So incisors, one side if we take two, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So two jaws, it is 8 in number, and the teeth are said to be sharp. They have sharp edge. This. So what for it is helping? For biting the food. Suppose if you are taking any fruit or vegetable or biscuit, we are biting it. So that is happening because of incisors. Then canines. So this side canines. So one side 2 up and down. So both sides it 4. So they are having sharp pointed edge. So tearing the food. So like sugar cane if you want to tear, or meat if you want to tear. So that tearing of food is going to happen because of a canine teeth. Then premolars and molars, if you take, they are blunt and flat surface they have, and premolars are 8 in number next to canines, 2, okay, so 8 in number, and molars back of the jaws they are said to be 12 in number, and they are going to help in chewing the food and masticating the food and grinding the food. So there is relation between the shape of the teeth and the function what they are going to do. Is it clear to children? So the human dental formula is said to be ICPM 2123. Very important for your exam bits, it will be given. So these are about the different types of teeth and the different functions which are going to be carried out by the teeth. Is it clear to you? So if you observe that arrangement of teeth, and are they going alone helping in the grinding or masticating the food, means no. So yeah, the muscles, circular muscles which are present in the mouth along with the tongue, then teeth, they are going to help in moving the food up and down, then grinding the food and crushing the food. All that process of the food, what it is happening in the buccal cavity, it is called as a mastication. So all whatever food which we are keeping in the buccal cavity, it cannot be swallowed. Is it not, children? So different food items we are going to eat. Some are solid, some are liquid. So as it is, they cannot go. So they have to change their what is that form. Okay, so that is happening because of the process called mastication. Is it clear to you? So here, the fifth cranial nerve. Which is a component of nervous system. So, fifth cranial nerve is also helping in bringing the movements of the buccal cavity. So, the parts which are associated are present in the buccal cavity, like tongue, then muscles, jaws. Continuously will be observing the lower jaw, how it is moving up and down to bring the process of mastication. So that all is monitored by the fifth cranial nerve. Is it clear to children? So that what will happen means the surface area of the food will increase because of the grinding or crushing, which we call it as mastication. So that the food is going to become very much bolus in nature, little bit soft, and it is easy to swallow the food. That swallowing food, it is going to happen through the esophagus, and it will enter into the stomach, where the process of further digestion is going to happen. That we will discuss tomorrow. Thank you.